In order to get the most time savings from your account with ShipStation, you'll more than likely want to set up some automation rules. Automation rules are customizable and hierarchical sets of criteria and actions that run whenever an order is imported into your ShipStation account. Think of it like an if this, then that recipe. If whatever criteria you set happens, then do that, some action or actions that you choose. To best demonstrate this, let's go over a couple of examples. Let's say that I want to insure all of my international orders. To do this automatically by using an automation rule, we'll first go to the settings area. So click on the gear in the top right of the screen, and then click on automation rules. Now click on create a rule, and we'll have some choices. The first thing is to just name our rule. So in this case, we'll call it insure international orders. Next, we have to choose the criteria. Since we want this to apply to orders originating from anywhere outside the United States, and we don't already have that as a saved filter, we'll just choose to select the criteria now. So choose Add Criteria, find Country, and then does not equal United States. Now we have to choose the action, or what ShipStation will do when that order comes in that matches our criteria. For this example, we'll choose Insure the order, and then we'll choose ShipSurance. Click Save Changes, and now our automation rule is created. For this test store, I'm selling jewelry, so any order with one or two items in it will receive a free polishing cloth. Any orders with three or more items, however, will get a full polishing kit. So, back in our automation rules area, I'm going to add my first rule. So we're going to click create a rule, and we'll name this one polishing cloth. Choose our on-the-fly criteria, and then make sure that the total quantity is less than three. And now I need to add my action of adjust the order weight, and then by 2 ounces. You can also subtract weight by adding a minus sign to the beginning of the number. Now, we're going to click Save Changes, and I'm ready to add my second rule. So click Create a Rule again, and now we're going to name this Polishing Kit. We're going to do on-the-fly filters again, so we're going to add a criteria of total quantity is greater than or equal to 3. And then we're going to have to add both of our actions. So the first one is to adjust the order weight by 4 ounces. And then we'll add the action of changing the box size. Set package dimensions to 5 by 5 by 3. So now I'll click Save Changes. And now any of my orders that come in will have the appropriate weight and box size changed to accommodate for the polishing stuff. The last example is to always include a return label with each of my outgoing orders. To do this, we'll just click Create a Rule. We're going to name this Return Label. And now we're actually going to make sure that this applies to every order that's imported into my store. So we're just going to leave this as is. Now, go down to Add an Action. And then we're going to find Include a Return Label. And we're just going to choose UPS Ground and Package, since I don't want to prepay for these. Click Save Changes, and that's it. To check whether an order has had an automation rule, or any other automation feature for that matter, applied to it, you can open the order on the Orders grid by either double-clicking it, or clicking the order number, and then scrolling down to the Order Activity area. Click on this to open it, and then you can see exactly what's been done to that order. For more videos on the features of ShipStation, visit us at ShipStation.com/videos.